find a seat. I am both sad that it's our last day of Treasure VBS, but I'm also excited because we've had such a great week, haven't we? Yes, it has been awesome. And we've got one more great night in store for you. But first, let's stand, let's sing our theme song together.
Priceless treasure. God knows me, God hears me, God is my comfort. I am His and there's nothing better. Forgiven and chosen forever. I am a treasure. I am a priceless treasure. God knows.
Finding treasure, right? And sometimes treasure hunters, they have to use a map, right? We've talked about that. X marks the spot. Sometimes treasure hunters, they have to figure out riddles, right? They got this puzzle that they've got to work out, and that's the clue that points them on the way. Other times, treasure hunters need to rely on other people for help. And we're going to talk a little bit more about that, and we're going to do that with a game. So I need a volunteer in the form of a crew leader. Can I get a crew leader to come up here? Jonah, come on up. All right. So Jonah, come on, quick. What you're going to do is you're going to face away. I need you to plug your ears for me. All right? What we're going to do is we are going to hide this treasure hat. And remember, we don't want to tell them where it is, okay? So don't tell them, but I want all of you to see where it is, okay? All right. And then what we're going to do is when he's getting closer towards it, we're going to clap more loudly, right? And if he's further away, we're going to clap quietly. Does that make sense? It's hot and cold, right? Okay? All right, Jonah. So we have hidden that orange hat that I just had. I just hid it somewhere in this room here. And your friends are going to help you try to find it. Okay? So when we clap louder, means you're on the right track. When we clap quieter, you're going the wrong way. You guys think we're up for this?
Yeah.
Remember, don't tell them. We're going to be silent. We're only going to use our claps. 3, 2, 1, go. And good job to all of you, friends. Way to go. Now, we worked together there. We were friends to Jonah and helped him out, right? And we helped him out, which was a good thing. But I want you guys to circle up and talk as a crew. What if we didn't help him out? What if we were all just clapping randomly? I want you to talk and imagine what would have happened then. Go ahead. We all just were clapping like crazy on Jonah. Jakey, go ahead. It would have been hard for him. Yeah. What else would have happened?
He'd be all over the
place, right? It'd be almost impossible. Yep.
A mess.
It'd be a mess. I think you're right. You know, sometimes we have people in our lives that maybe they don't say helpful things to us or kind things, and they kind of make us confused, make us feel a little lost. But as we've been learning this week, we have a God that we can always trust, that we can always go to, and He will always lead us the right way. Now, God does put people in our lives, boys and girls, that can help us too. They can encourage us. They can help point us the right way. They can help us see God. We've been talking about God sightings all week, right? Everybody got your bracelet? And we've been talking about all these ways, the things that we see and hear and taste and touch that remind us of God. Hey, boys and girls. And what I want us to do now is I want us to talk about God's sightings specifically with people. Maybe something someone said or did that reminded you of God's love. Go ahead and circle back up in your group and talk about that for a minute. Once again, I want to hear from a few of you. What's a God sighting that you've had where you saw someone else do something that reminded you of God? Go ahead, Allie. God. Go ahead. This guy. Okay, someone with people. What's something someone else has done? Jesus, yeah. Jesus, we learned yesterday, died for our sins and rose again. Awesome. Who else? Back there. All right, your mom took you to the movies. Awesome. You got to spend time together with your mom. Go ahead.
It was a sunny day.
It's a sunny day? Yeah. Yeah. One other band. Somebody did remind you of God. The stars. Yeah. Some of the person did. Go ahead. One more. Someone from your karate class. Awesome. So. Okay. Okay, all right, very cool. Very cool. So, hey, it's our last night at Treasure and BBS, but even as we leave this place, I want to encourage you guys to continue to be on the lookout for God. See the ways, the things that remind you of God, that He's close to us in our lives. The worship team's going to come up, and crew leaders, we are going to put up our jewels one last time all over our set to remind us of all the ways that we can see God in our lives. Kiddos, stand up and sing this song together. Singing. Way to go. You guys hear that? Wait, it's my phone. Wait, Dr. Diggingstone is calling me. Hi, Doc.
Hi, Joe. Oh, good, you were all there. I just wanted to call and say goodbye because I'm packing up to go home.
Oh, you're leaving already?
Yes. Didn't find the treasure I was looking for. I think maybe you got some bad information about there being a treasure around here. I need to ask you a question. Why were you all so nice to me when we first met? I was really mean to you, but none of you were mean to me. That doesn't happen with a lot of treasure hunters I know.
Well, we all know that God loves us, and He loves you too. And we want to treat our friends like God does. To God, you are priceless. You are a treasure. As we're going to learn today, God chooses you.
I'm not sure you have that quite right. I look for treasure. I'm not treasure. At least, I don't feel like treasure.
You know, we all have days like that. But God loves us on good days, on hard days, every day.
And you're saying God chooses me? Like, He picks me?
Yep, that's right.
That doesn't happen very often either. In fact, the whole reason I became a treasure hunter was because people didn't pick me to play ball with them at the playground. So I went off to play by myself and ended up finding some change in the grass. Treasure.
You're so valuable to God, He chooses you every time.
Well, I want to know more. I want to choose God back.
That's awesome. That's the most valuable thing you could ever do. Hey, Doc, let me wrap up with the kids here, and then I'll call you back in a minute, and we can talk more about how God loves you.
Okay, that sounds great. We'll talk later. But goodbye, everyone. See you in the kids' room.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye. Well, I'm bummed that Dr. Diggingstone couldn't be here with us one last night, but I'm so glad she called, and I'm so glad she finally wants to learn more about the real treasure, that she is the treasure, that she is priceless to God. Isn't that great that she finally got it? I am excited. And I'm excited because I think it's because of all these wonderful Bible truths we've been learning. It finally helped Doctor understand. And I hope you boys and girls understand too, these great truths that we've been learning this week. Let's go over them one more time really quick. The first night, our buddy Pogo here helped us remember that God knows you.
Yeah!
And then the next night, beautiful bird Ruby here helped us to remember that God hears you.
Yeah!
You And then this silly little monkey back here, Wilder, reminded us on the third night that God comforts you.
Yeah.
And then last night, beautiful butterfly Grace reminds us this amazing truth that God forgives you.
Yeah.
And then finally tonight, we've got our last Bible buddy, this ferocious looking guy, Raymond, helps us to know that God chooses you.
Yeah.
Let's learn more about Raymond, our Bible buddy, on this video.
Are you ready for the rest of the quest? Welcome back to another day of adventure. Meet Raymond. You probably think you know what animal he is, but everyone gets this wrong. Alligator? Crocodile? Nope. Raymond is a caiman, kin to those bigger guys. You might say he's greater than a gator with crocodile style. Here's a quick family tree. Raymond's family is called crocodilians. In that family, there are alligators, crocodiles, and gharials. Sort of like the way you have aunts, uncles, cousins, second cousins, you get the idea. Of course, there are different kinds of crocodiles, alligators, and gharials. And he's right there, under the alligator branch. Got it? One way to tell them apart is by where they live. Caimans like the warm, tropical water found in rivers or swamps in Central and South America. Raymond prefers his water fresh, but some of his caiman cousins like salt water. Usually, they're pretty quiet. After all, he can't be too noisy or he'd scare away his dinner. But sometimes, Raymond needs to give a shout out to his buddies. Raymond's lungs fill up so much that the water on his back vibrates. We're not saying he's lazy, but he does spend most of his day just basking in the sun. Oh, time for another nap. Out here, there aren't many animals that hunt caimans, so Raymond doesn't even have to keep an eye out to stay safe. Of course, it's always good to keep watch when these guys are sneaking around. Speaking of sneaking, Raymond can be pretty sneaky too. God put Raymond's eyes and nose on the top of his head. That way he can slowly swim through the water and sneak up on a snack. Yum! And when Raymond decides to take a bite, it's a big bite. God gave these reptiles plenty of sharp teeth and some of the strongest jaws on the planet. Grabbing lunch is a snap. Raymond needs all the tricks and help he can get to catch food. On land, his legs are pretty short. Let's just say he won't be winning any prizes for running. But water is another thing. Caimans have such strong tails that they don't even need to use their legs. Ah, nothing like a nice, slow swim. God gave Raymond all kinds of ways to blend in and camouflage, so he stays safe and eats the food he needs to grow. For Raymond the Caiman, blending in and going unnoticed is a good thing. But for people, I think it's kind of different. Most of the time, you don't like just blending into the crowd. You like it when people see you and choose you for something. It feels good when someone knows your name and wants you for a friend. Well, I have golden news for you. God chooses you. You're a treasure. In the Bible, God has this message for his family. I have called you by name. You are mine. To God, you don't blend into the crowd. You're special, amazing, unique, awesome. God has important plans just for you. God chooses you. You are treasured.
Isn't Raymond cool? Who thinks they can make a good Raymond noise? Did you hear what he was doing? It's kind of a low. Give it a try. Yeah. I love this Bible point today, boys and girls, because think about all the stars in the sky. Think about all the different animals on creation, all the different plants and bodies of water and everything in this world. And at the same time, God looks at each and every one of us, and he cares about us. He's involved in our lives, and he chooses us for something special. We're going to learn more about that today. It's going to be an awesome thing. Hey, there are some treasures in this room that have been awesome all week, and that is your crew leaders. So I want you guys all to stand up really quick and to give a big thank you to your crew leader for hanging out with you all week. A high five, an elbow, just say thank you to them. Your crew leaders are wonderful. Thank you so much. Yes. All right. All right, let's bring it up here one last time, boys and girls. It is time to say goodbye to me, our last time. Before you go, you have a minute. Go ahead and choose your crew jobs. Decide who's going to do what. Again, you got a few extra minutes this time, so take your time with that, and then slowly make your way to your first station. Have fun.
Welcome back to Bible Adventures. Today, we're going to explore another totally true adventure straight from the Bible. Today's true story from the Bible has a pretty complicated plot, so we won't have time to go into all the details, but you can read the whole exciting adventure in your Bible at home later today. It's all in the book of Esther. As this book of the Bible opens, Esther is in an incredible position. Let me quickly give you a little background. The king of Persia had decided to find a new queen. He sent agents into every part of the kingdom to find young women and bring them to the palace. The women would get beauty treatments for a year, and then the king would choose a new queen. This is where Esther comes in. I know, this sounds kind of like a fairy tale, doesn't it? Cinderella or something like that, but it really happened. Hey, maybe that's where Disney got the idea. Anyway, a man named Mordecai lived right near the palace, and his cousin named Esther lived with his family. When her parents died, Mordecai had adopted Esther. All of them were Jews who had been forced out of Jerusalem. So Esther was taken to the king's palace with a bunch of other women. Each young woman got the beauty treatments for 12 months. Well, after a year, the king set the royal crown on Esther's head and chose her as the queen.
Oh, my. I didn't expect anyone to be here. Excuse me, but who are you? And how did you get into the royal palace?
Hi, Esther. We were just talking about you.
Oh, really? But who are you? Are you friends? Oh, I hope you're friends. I could really use some friends right now.
Yes, Esther, we're your friends. We believe in the one true God, just like you do.
Shh, not so loud. Shh. Yes, it's true. I am a Jew, and I do believe in God, but, well, my cousin, Mordecai, advised me not to tell anyone at the palace that I'm a Jew, and Mordecai's always helped me, so I did what he said.
You know, friends, Esther has Mordecai and her family to help her do the right thing. Right now, say the name of a family member who helps you do the right thing.
I'm so glad you have family members who will help you out. And I'm so glad you're my new friends. Will you help me out?
What's going on?
I'm in a real spot. There's this awful man, Haman. He's a powerful advisor to the king, and, well, Haman decided that everyone in the kingdom should bow down when he passed by, but Mordecai refused. Of course, Mordecai would only bow before God, not silly old Haman.
That makes sense.
But that made Haman really mad. Haman knows that Mordecai is a Jew, so Haman told the king that there's this troublesome group of people who won't follow the king's rules. He meant the Jews, of course. So he convinced the king to kill all the Jews.
That's horrible.
I know, and now Mordecai says I need to go before the king and beg for my people's lives. But the king doesn't even know I'm a Jew. And what's worse, everyone knows that if I go before the king without being invited, he, well, I can't even say it. He could have me killed. Anyone who appears before the king without being invited is doomed to die, unless the king holds out his scepter. That's this big, shiny stick thing, and what are the chances of that? If I go before the king, I'm probably going to die.
Esther, what are you gonna do? Are you willing to die?
Well, it's not on my list of favorite things to do today, but Mordecai sent me a message that's helping me. He said, don't think for a moment that because you're in the palace, you'll escape when all the other Jews are killed. Who knows if perhaps you were made queen for just such a time as this?
Wow! It sounds like God chose you to be queen just for this reason. But what are you gonna do?
I asked Mordecai to tell all the Jews to fast for me, not to eat or drink for 3 days. My maids and I would do the same. We'd all turn to God and ask for his help. Then, after 3 days, I'd go before the king. Today is day 3. The time has come. My new friends, will you help me?
Friends, what do you think? Can we help Esther?
If the king doesn't kill me right away when I go before him, and that's a big if, I'm going to ask the king and Haman to come to a banquet that I prepare. At the banquet, I'll let the king know of Haman's plot, and I'll tell the king that I'm a Jew.
Well, how can we help?
Well, just in case it all goes well, you could help prepare the banquet. Just grab a snack wherever you are, some fruit snacks, crackers, or a bit of cereal. My servants here will be getting a feast ready, so you can join in. He's in the throne room. Oh no, what am I going to do? I can't do this. Why did God choose me for this? Okay, I'm going in now.
Esther, God chose you for this job. He'll help you, and we can help you too. Let's call out some encouragement to Esther. Call out some encouragement to Esther right where you are. I know you can do it. God is with you. I know something that's true for all of you. God has chosen you to be His friend. He said this through the prophet Isaiah, "I have called you by name. You are mine." And later, God inspired the apostle Paul to write, "So now we can rejoice in our wonderful new relationship with God, because our Lord Jesus Christ had made us friends of God." Just like God chose Esther, God chooses you. You are treasured.
My friends, thank you for helping me stand strong. The king didn't kill me. Well, I guess that's obvious, but look, I'm alive. Maybe God did choose me to be queen so I could help my people. God chose me, and I just know that God has chosen each of you for something amazing too. Anyway, I have to hurry now and dress for the banquet. Thank you again for being such treasured friends.
That was so cool, getting to meet Esther, a queen. The Bible tells us the king was furious with Haman and got rid of him. Then he put Mordecai in charge of all Haman's property. But best of all, the Jews were saved. All because one young woman did what God had chosen her to do. I can't wait to see what God has in store for each of you, because you are treasured.
I'm Genevieve, and I'm 11 years old. I live with my mom, my dad, my sister, and my cousin in Orange County, California.
Genevieve likes spending time with her family. She likes to play with her sister. Her family watches movies together, swims, and goes on walks. Genevieve also does ballet, but what she really loves is swimming. Genevieve and her sister started swimming lessons when she was around 8 years old. One day, her instructors chose her to be part of a swimming club where she would race other swimmers. At first, Genevieve didn't feel very strong about her swimming, but one day, something amazing happened.
I remember one time that I was doing swimming. It was a normal practice, and at this time, I was probably one of the slowest people in my group. And then I was just swimming, and then all of a sudden, I felt this holy power that I could go faster, and I passed every single person in my lane, and I ended up being the fastest person from that day on.
Being chosen means Genevieve is part of a team. That team is a lot like a family. The coaches wanted Genevieve to be part of their team because they knew she could do great things. Being chosen for the swim team means Genevieve must train hard. She practices 5 days a week for 2.5 hours each day. Genevieve relies on her coaches and trainers to help her become a better, faster swimmer. She also relies on God too.
I normally rely on God to help me with my races. Like, I normally get kind of scared before a race, so I ask Him to help me like become kind of more confident with myself, and that He will love me no matter what I get.
Genevieve hopes to be able to go to the Olympics and win a gold medal in swimming. She'll have to work hard every day for many more years to be chosen for that team. Genevieve knows that she's already been chosen as part of God's family, and she didn't have to work for that at all. God chose her just because He loves her. Did you know that you've been chosen to be part of God's family too? In the Bible, the book of Isaiah says, "I have called you by name. You are mine." That's right. God chooses you and He calls you His very own. You don't have to work or earn God's love. He picks you as His friend just because. God made you for a purpose. You can ask God to show you what He has chosen you to do. God will help you do amazing things. God chooses you. You are treasured.
To Imagination Station. It's hard to believe this is our last day. Today, we're discovering that God chooses you. You are treasured. But before we dig into that, I get to ask you one last time. Did you bring your imagination today? Today, we're going to need loads and loads of imagination. I was just talking to my friend Raymond, the caiman, and you won't believe what he told me. Did you know a caiman can run up to 30 miles per hour? That's as fast as a car. Whoa, amazing. Hop up. Let's pretend you're in a race with Raymond. Let's see how fast you can run in place, right where you're at. Run as fast as you can in place. You kids are crazy fast, but I'm not sure that you could beat Raymond in a race. That fellow is fast. Now that your imaginations are moving, let's find out today's question. Do you think caimans sense vibrations in the water from prey with their jaws or with their claws? Okay, time for the drum roll so I can reveal the amazing answer. And the answer is their jaws. They have bundles of nerve fibers only in their jaws, which help them sense vibrations made by nearby prey. Imagine that. Before we have fun with our last sciencey fun gizmo, let's do some exploring. We've met our friend Raymond the caiman. One thing I notice about him is that he blends right in with the plants and trees and grass. That's called camouflage. When an animal is camouflaged, that means God designed it to blend in with its habitat and protect it. I have a challenge for you now. I'll put some images on screen. See if you can see an animal hiding in the picture. Did you spot this guy? Nope. No one hiding here. Who's hiding here? Did you see this friend? No critters here. Wow, this guy really blends in. It's amazing how well critters can hide when they're camouflaged. Let's see if you can camouflage a furry friend at home. Go find a small stuffed animal and hide it in a place where it's visible, but it blends in. This is my friend, the camel. I'm gonna put him right over here. Under some tan ferns. He is camouflaged. Ready? Now you try.
knew some animals needed to blend in for safety. I don't know about you, but sometimes I feel like I blend into the background too, almost like nobody sees me. Have you ever felt like that? The good news is God always sees you and me. We don't blend into the background. God knows you. He even knows every hair on your head. He has a special plan for you, and He loves you. God chooses you. You are treasured. Now, it's time to discover our science-y fun gizmo. It's called a Rolling Raymond, in honor of our friend, Raymond the Cayman. You can choose which way to roll Raymond the Cayman by tipping a tray or a plate. The little marble inside makes him roll along whichever way you choose. Follow along with me to make your own Raymond the Cayman, step by step. First, you'll color the printed side of the cardboard piece. Next, with the printed side out, slightly fold the crease on Raymond's back and snout. Now, hold the underside, where Raymond's belly is, in a place so the straight edge is square with the slits at his neck. Tape it in place at the armpit and base of tail. Ready? Gently bend up the neck and bend the tail at the fold line so Raymond's body lays flat on a surface. Fold his feet down just slightly at the fold lines. Finally, gently press a marble into the hole in Raymond's belly. Set Rolling Raymond on a plate or tray and tip it to move him around. You even got a Try This at Home sticker to remind you of the way Raymond connects with God's Word. Put that sticker on a Ziploc bag and give Raymond a safe place to stay. Thanks for joining me at Imagination Station this week.
Amazing that God, the creator of the whole universe, knows our names. He knows every one of us. Isn't that incredible? Let's cool if our churches had that all the time? Every Sunday we come and we put up a sparkly gem for the God sightings we saw that week. That would be so awesome, wouldn't it? So, in your cruise during PBS this week, you've seen God sightings and Totally True Bible Adventures, lots of smiles and hugs, praising God with music. So right now, I need you guys to call out one thing that you treasured or a God sighting where you saw God's love at Vacation Bible School this week. Raise your hand up. Just call it. Sayla, what did you see?
Adriana.
She was your God sighting. You saw God's love through her. Samuel. Your cousin Eden. You saw God's love through her. Yes. The entire thing was God sighting to you. Ellie, what was your God sighting? Thank you. Yes, buddy, what was your God saying? You made a new friend. That's so awesome. Nolan, what was your guys' business? You're bringing your neighbor. Yes, we made so many friends this week. Yes, or random that I can't remember which one. The marshmallow gun was saying that this was God's love to you. Yes. Austin, what's happening, you guys? What? Great snacks! Evidence of God's love. One more. Kidman Cinema. You experienced God's love there. Oh, I love hearing these things. You know what? I know all of you guys have. Right now, if you didn't get a chance to say it out loud, go ahead and say it. What was your God sighting at PBS? God's love! Even though I may not have heard or understood all that, God did, right? Because God hears you. Well, I have treasured you. Boys and girls, write down this a little bit for me. I know you're excited. I treasure you guys so much. I'm so thankful for you. And I need to choose some of you to help me with an exciting activity we're going to do. So let's see. I've got a special way, though. I'm going to choose you. Hang on just a second. Can I have my animals and my gun and where's all that stuff? And my treasure, guys. Not a real God, sorry. Not a real God. No. You're helping me with this, right? Yeah. No. I need help. Come on, Ellie. You need to get out of here. Okay. Here is how I'm going to choose who gets to help. Pass out some treasure. We're going to pass out some treasure. And every crew will get some treasure tonight. So what we're going to do is we're going to shoot this animal, I've got several animals here, out of the marshmallow gun, into the crowd. And if you catch the animal, I want you to bring it up here and you're going to trade it in for some treasure. And you're going to pick a crew to give that treasure to. You're not going to pick your own crew. You're going to pick one of the other crews. So crews, get your signs up, okay? So that they know to pick you. And before you come get the treasure, you need to go to the crew that you're picking and ask how many kids are in that crew so you get the right amount of treasure, okay? All right, here you go, buddy.
Hey, moment.
It's in the first six rows. Hey!
African Republic. So great job, you guys.